According to estimates by policymakers, activists, and scholars, the number of modern-day slaves ranges from about 10 million to 30 million people. But how many of those slaves work for you? Now, that is the unsettling question being posed by a new online tool. It's called Slavery Footprint. It is the latest initiative from the anti-slavery call and response campaign in partnership with the U.S. State Department. It allows consumers to measure to what extent they are complicit in the use of forced labor around the world. And here is how it works. Now, users answer a series of 11 questions about their homes, habits, and consumption of everyday products. Take the question, what is under your roof? Now, you can add bedrooms, or you could add bathrooms, a home office, a car, a scooter, a variety of objects here. And then by pressing this wheel, you can then tally up how many items like light bulbs, pillows, and textiles you have. And according to anti-slavery activists, all of these items on this list have some connection to bonded labor. And you could check out the statistic on the right. More than 200,000 children are forced to work in India's carpet belt of Uttar Pradesh. That would make the operation bigger than companies like Sony and Boeing in terms of employees. Now, let's take a peek inside your medicine cabinet. And chances are you have a lot of these products in your bathroom. Sunscreen, soap, toothpaste. And you can click on any that you don't have. And here's the message. Every day, tens of thousands of women buy makeup. And activists say that every day, tens of thousands of Indian children are forced to mine for mica. That's the material that makes makeup sparkle. And this one is for all you gadget geeks out there. If you have any of these electronic products, from laptops to digital cameras, TVs to MP3 players, listen up. They contain coltan. This is a metal used as a superconductor and mined by slaves in countries like the Democratic Republic of Congo. Of course, the point of answering all these questions is to give an idea of how many slaves might make the products you use. And the survey uses a formula based on where the raw materials for each product comes from and where finished items are made, so you end up with a slavery footprint score. Now, each and every one of us form a part of the slave supply chain, even if we're not aware of it. And of course, the idea is for us to use this information and to take action. And you could share your results on Facebook or Twitter, or you could send a letter to a company telling them you want to know about the use of modern-day slavery in their supply chains. The slavery footprint's poignant question applies to corporations as well. How many slaves work for you? So how many slaves work for anti-slavery activist Justin Dillon, who leads the call and response campaign? Well, I caught up with the man behind this latest app just a little earlier.
I took the survey last night, and sadly, I have about 86 people forced to work for me to produce the lifestyle that I enjoy.
And with this application, with this knowledge that you want to share with other people, what do you hope to achieve with the Slavery Footprint app?
Well, with Slavery Footprint, what we didn't want to do is just create another calculator that only spits out bad news. What I believe is that people carry around stories and not necessarily statistics. So with Slavery Footprint, we actually want to be able to tell you the story of your life and how it fits in with a globalized economy. Today, slavery is worse now than it ever was before, but most people have a hard time of understanding how it affects their lives. Slavery Footprint is the first chapter for most people in understanding how it directly affects their lives, but most importantly, about what they can do to change it.
Now, you worked with the U.S. State Department to create this app. What kind of support did they give you?
Well, they were phenomenal, not only in their sharing of knowledge, but they helped the beginning of the funding of the app, and really, we're able to use a lot of their relational equity to be able to bring the right kind of experts and stakeholders to bear on this. The technology that we've created and the algorithm that we've created around Slavery Footprint is a very vetted and multi-stakeholder approach, where we're able to use vetted data to be able to determine the slavery in different types of products that we use every day while being very brand agnostic. We don't go after any particular brand. We're talking about different types of products that you use every day, which is very important.
Now, this new app, it follows the call and response app, as well as your documentary of the same name. So do you feel that consumers are taking notice? Do you feel that the concept of buying slave-free is really gaining traction now?
Well, I think we're getting there. I think we've just lit the fuse on the rocket. What's really going to make the rocket take off is if a consumer start to embed the story of other people who are being exploited to produce their lifestyles. If consumers can start to absorb that, that story into their lives, and more importantly, amplify that story in the marketplace.